The Ram Rider.
Been referred to by the Guinness Book of World Records as the most fearless animal in all of the animal kingdom. It really doesn't give a if it's hungry, it's hungry. Ew, what's that in its mouth? It really doesn't give a If it's hungry, it's hungry. Ew.
The balance changes are upon us, and you are probably seeing a whole lot of bait, a whole lot of giant double prince, and a whole lot of three musketeers. Actually, I've been seeing, I feel like giant double prince has been like all over the place. And if that has been your struggle, well, I'm here to make your day, guys, because this deck is absolutely amazing in the current meta. Now, I actually tried this deck out shortly before the balance changes hit. And I was like, okay, it's pretty good. It's pretty solid right now. P.E.K.K.A control still in a good spot. But man, after the balance changes, I tried it again. And I actually did surprisingly well. I had a pretty good run in the classic challenge. One of the better ones that I've done in a while. So really quickly, guys, if you're wondering, what the heck was that crazy intro? Well, hashtag only 90 kids will remember. Only 90s kids will remember, sorry. It's basically a reference to the Honey Badger video, which was a viral YouTube video like 9 years ago or something like that. I'll make sure to link the original video in the description so you can go and check out the madness, the original madness, if you're interested in wondering where that came from. But let's go ahead and focus on the deck here now. So, as I mentioned, it's still a really solid deck. It's gonna stomp giant double prints for the most part because you got that P.E.K.K.A in there. You got the Ram Rider to like slow them down, slow down the giant, slow down the prince, lock them in place, all kinds of cool stuff, but mostly focusing around that P.E.K.K.A control aspect. P.E.K.K.A just annihilates giant, does really well against prince and dark prince as well. Obviously, the only one like downside to that would be the P.E.K.K.A's first swing being negated by the Dark Prince's shield. But other than that, P.E.K.K.A is pretty solid against all of those cards. So definitely a really good deck for the current meta. It's definitely a control deck. So you're playing this much like a control deck, just like most P.E.K.K.A decks are. Now, I mean, you can use P.E.K.K.A in like old school P.E.K.K.A beatdown decks. But honestly, it's such a heavy, she's such a heavy hitter, and she moves so slow and everything. The way that the card is crafted is, it's really focused around control decks. It's, you can build up a push behind the P.E.K.K.A, but you know, when you invest a P.E.K.K.A in the back, they just put their giant in the opposite lane, your P.E.K.K.A's wasted, so on and so forth. So you do have that option of cycling her in the back, but generally, you're going to be using the P.E.K.K.A on defense. And once she's defended successfully, which she's likely to do with some support maybe, she's going to provide this really deadly, really threatening counter-push threat that your opponent absolutely has to answer. And if they don't answer it, one swing from a P.E.K.K.A does an insane amount of damage to the tower. And look at that Ram Rider usage there, locking that goal in place, or giant, excuse me. I'm going to talk a little bit more about the Ram Rider in the future here, but I just wanted to point that out while it was at hand there in the replay. So you're rarely ever going to use the P.E.K.K.A in the back or offensively at the bridge. I mean, the time calls for it, and you'll have to make that situational awareness call. But for the most part, if you are wondering how to play this deck, when to use the P.E.K.K.A, you basically only use her on defense. And honestly, you could even hang on till double elixir or like later in the game. You can completely catch your opponent off guard. Consider it like kind of a pocket card in a sense. And, you know, don't use it until you really need to. Now, in this case, because I'm going up against Giant, like, P.E.K.K.A is really important in countering that deck. So I wasn't hesitant to use her early on. However, if I was going up against, I don't know, maybe a Hog Cycle deck or something like that, where, yeah, P.E.K.K.A is great to counter the Hog, but maybe I just haven't had that opportune time to use her, something like that, or maybe a bait deck or whatever, you can hang on to her, save her, and use her late game. Look at this, he didn't answer my P.E.K.K.A fully and it almost destroyed that tower. So that's the counter push threat. I used her on defense there, and then he absolutely had to answer her. All that he had was a Mega Minion and it wasn't enough to DPS her down before she connected to the tower. So she got two swings off onto the tower, and she hit the giant there a little bit as well. But, it was okay. She did her job, and she got a bunch of damage off into the tower after successfully defending. So it worked out pretty well for me. Now, this particular replay is up against another P.E.K.K.A Ram Rider deck? Ram Rider, or is it Royal Hogs? Anyway, we'll see. It's another P.E.K.K.A control style deck. It's got Furnace in it and everything. So, anyway, guys, let's get back to the strategies at hand here. So that's pretty much it for P.E.K.K.A. Use her on defense. Consider hanging on to her. Don't just waste her willy-nilly. Consider even using her as a pocket card, waiting until your opponent, you know, how do I say this? Waiting for a very opportune time to use it so that your opponent is not expecting it and you catch them off guard. Now, going up against another P.E.K.K.A, you'll see I almost entirely, almost every single time, use her purely on defense against his P.E.K.K.A. And this is just a pretty core concept of this game, but in case you're unfamiliar with why, well, on defense, your cards are always gonna win an equal fight because you got the support of the Princess Tower in your territory. So, his P.E.K.K.A versus my P.E.K.K.A plus my Princess Tower, I'm gonna pull out ahead, I'm gonna gain that Elixir advantage, and then my P.E.K.K.A, like so, is going to live and provide a lot of threat on a counter push. So going up against a mirror match or another P.E.K.K.A deck, almost always, if opportunity allows you to, almost always wait for their P.E.K.K.A and then use yours on defense. Well, and then as I mentioned a million times by now, it'll provide that counter push threat. I'll try not to repeat that a million more times. I know I've said it a whole bunch by now. All right, guys, that's enough about the P.E.K.K.A. Let's talk about the Ram Rider. Now, the Ram Rider is another card that you use primarily on defense, and I know that sounds kind of funky to you guys right now. You're like, wait a second, why would I use the Ram Rider on defense? She's a win condition, right? Well, yeah, she is, but she's not a Hog Rider, she's not a Battle Ram, she's not a giant. She doesn't just go straight for the tower and that's her only plan, that's her only target, that's her only business is, oh, take out that tower. She has this huge defensive potential. She's got this room for defense because that snare effect, that auto attack, she could practically hold things in place, as you saw earlier with that giant, right? Now, again, she doesn't do too much damage herself, but she holds things in place so that everything else can wail away onto whatever the target is. So she's slowing that giant. I know it's like 85% slow now, but come on, guys. It's basically 100%. Like, that 85% slow, it's practically 100. I feel like they didn't even need to do that. Like, that was such a minor, insignificant tweak. Stuff is practically still held in place completely. It moves really slowly. I guess you could argue if it was an inch away from the tower, it would now be able to connect, so there's a minor change. But honestly, it feels like it just holds stuff in place still. It feels like it's 100% immobilized, the snare. Anyway, you can use her on pure offense. You can use her at the bridge if you have to, if you're trying to get damage onto their tower, so on and so forth. But you're primarily going to be using her on defense and then allowing her to go onto an offensive counter push, because she just, you don't want to invest all 5 elixir into just getting offense onto their tower. You want to be able to make sure that you get some value with her as well. If you're just going to be playing like an offensive deck and you're just going to be playing, you know, Ram Rider or or you're just going to be playing Hog Rider or Battle Ram, then the playstyle is going to be a little bit different. And those are viable replacements for this card, don't get me wrong, but you want to make sure to try to get that extra value out of her since she costs that one more elixir. Now, guys, this is actually a loss here in this particular replay, but I wanted to share it with you guys anyway, maybe point out some of the places where I went wrong, how I could have done things better. I might be focusing more on strategy because I still got a whole lot to share with you guys, but just we'll try to point out some mistakes that I made while the replay is going on. All right, so again, try to use that Ram Rider on defense. Try to get some value with her. Use her on defense to slow something down with some support to counter whatever their push is, and then she's going to go on to offense and provide a lot of counter threat. And I mean, she's really cool with that snare effect. It can hold like a prince in place if it's too far away so that it can't charge into her, even if she's going on offense. So take advantage of that snare effect. Don't just be placing her at the bridge by herself every time. Try to make use of her. All right, guys, opening moves. One of the common opening moves that you could do would be the baby dragon in the back. That's something that I like to do a little bit more often than not. It's kind of tanky, it's got high HP, it's got splash damage. It's just a safe move to make. It moves slow, it'll provide some defense down one lane. There's not too much else that you could do. You could bandit in the back, although I've actually been finding the bandit at the bridge to be pretty beneficial. Oftentimes they won't react in time to counter the bandit at the bridge, and you can get a swing or two off onto the tower. There was my first mistake, using the barbarian a little bit late, allowing the prince to connect to my tower, not defending against it enough. Man, look at that. It does like almost half the tower's damage just with those few jabs. Another few options for opening moves. You could definitely use the Electro Wizard, the E-Wiz in the back. He's a great card to open with, provides good defense. But you could also consider hanging on to him for counter pushes for defense because of his Enter the Arena effect, his stun effect, all that kind of good stuff. And keep in mind, guys, one of the reasons you have the E-Wiz in here is for that stun effect to counter Infernos that'll be countering your P.E.K.K.A. All right. Last thing for the E-Wiz, if you do use him in the back, you're susceptible for him to dying to fireballs and things like that. You could also bar barrel at the bridge. That's definitely a viable option. You don't need to ignore that. If they don't answer it, it's going to get one or two swings off onto the tower. If they do answer it, you're forcing an answer out of them. You're forcing them to invest some elixir into countering just your Barb Barrel. Now, this is where it kind of falls apart and I start losing it here. But anyway, let's skim over card replacements really quick. For the Bandit, you want to go for another, like, kind of charge unit, maybe like a Prince. If you just want another, like, mini tank, you go with a Valkyrie or a Knight. For the Baby Dragon, another range support. My go-to replacement for the Baby Dragon is usually the Executioner. Plays a similar role with its splash damage, costs 5 elixir, it's beefy. You could also maybe go for like a Wizard or even like a Musketeer. For the E-Wizard, you probably want an E-Drag or Zappies in there because you want that stun effect. As I mentioned, you're naturally going to be seeing like Inferno Dragons and Inferno Towers countering your P.E.K.K.A. So in order to counter that Inferno Dragon or Inferno Tower, you got the stun effect, you got the E-Wiz in there, or the E-Drag or something like that. For the Ram Rider, as I mentioned, you could put another win condition in there. You could go like Battle Ram or Hog Rider, but that would make it a lot more direct going straight for the tower, and you're not going to be playing this as much of a control deck. I mean, you will. There are P.E.K.K.A. Battle Ram decks out there that have been popular forever, but it changes the playstyle a little bit. So just get another win condition in there. You could put a Giant or a Tank in there, but honestly, with these control decks, you're usually going for like a chargey, high damage win condition. So I would definitely include like a Battle Ram or a Hog Rider. And to wrap it up with a P.E.K.K.A, maybe you could replace her with like a Mega Knight if you want that control aspect. Big beef unit, has a lot of HP, costs the same amount of elixir, but doesn't target single targets, doesn't do massive damage to one target. He's got more of that splash effect. So it's an option, but if you want that really high DPS on a single target, which you kind of want in a control deck like this, then you may even just slap in a mini P.E.K.K.A in there. Alright guys, that is it for tonight. I hope that you enjoyed that goofy intro. I took some time to make it, and I'm pretty happy with how it came out. Make sure to leave the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. If you didn't, you can leave it a thumbs down. That's fine by me. Be honest. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. I cover balance changes, Clash Royale decks, a few other games, stuff like that, all the time. And of course, if you have any questions or want to share your opinion about this deck or anything like that, leave a comment in the comment section below. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys, and have a good evening.